Good morning students, welcome back to your English language class. In the previous video, we discussed article writing and today in this video, we are going to discuss another form of report writing, that is speech writing. So, the objectives of this session are, by the end of this session, you will be able to understand what is a speech writing, format of speech writing, and how to write an effective speech. So students, before proceeding further, we should know what is a speech writing. So, a speech writing is an art of conveying a message to your audience. It must have the capacity to hold the attention of the audience with a proper choice of words, expressions, and examples. Means, a speech writing is an art by which you can convey your message to your audience or listeners. Your speech should be so much convincing, students, that the audience glues to their seats to listen to you, whatever you say. So obviously, you should be very careful for the choice of words, expressions, examples, and idioms. Now, let us discuss how to write an effective speech. Now students, let us discuss a few important points which are to be kept while writing an effective speech. So, first point is, greet your audience and introduce the topic you are speaking on. Means, always greet your audience like good morning, good afternoon teachers, students, and everyone present here. And must introduce your topic on which you are going to speak on. Next point is, the introduction part of the speech is the most important part. So, it is that part which decides the impact of the speech. Means the introductory part of your speech is very important, as this is the part which leaves the impact of your speech on the listeners. Next is, the introduction should not be very lengthy. The main topic should be taken up as quickly as possible. Use simple and familiar language. Familiar language means the language is easily understood by everyone. So, the last is, the conclusion plays a very important role in the success of a speech. So, always give your own conclusion on the topic in a telling manner. Means, you have to conclude your speech very effectively. And the last point is, write thank you at the end of your speech. Now let us discuss format of a speech writing. Means when you are going to write a perfect speech, you should know the proper format. So a perfect speech must consist of heading. So the heading should be very catchy, and students, it should not be more than 5 to 6 words. Next is opening line. Now here students, this opening line includes salutations, introduction, and the topic. But make sure you do not mention your personal details like your name, school name. Next is body. Now students, this is the main part of your speech writing or of your writing piece. It is always prescribed that you begin with a short or precise introduction on the topic. Then you need to explain the current situation or the problems, if any, and whether after any corrective actions, betterment in the situation has been observed or not. It may include advantages, disadvantages, but depending upon the topic in question. So, next is concluding paragraph. Now, in this concluding paragraph, it is to be remembered that wherever you elaborate a problem, you always have to mention the steps being taken to improve the situation and suggest a few solutions as well. Last but not the least, the concluding line thanking the audience for their cooperation and their patience. it is very important, students, to conclude what you have started. So, never leave a speech open-ended. Now here, this is the format of speech writing. Introduction. Good morning to one and all present here. Second is express your views about the topic. Next, must highlight the advantages or disadvantages. Next, conclude the topic with suggestions, message or any advice. And at the end, thank the audience or students for their support. Now students, we are going to discuss a specimen speech writing. The instructions are, you are asked to speak in the morning assembly of your school on reading makes a ready man. So children, the topic of your speech is reading makes a ready man. And in the school assembly, in the morning assembly, you have to give a speech on the same topic. So obviously, we have already discussed, whatever kind of report writing you get, you must have the value points related to that report writing, with which you can elaborate your report writing. So here, related to this topic, we have the value points like views on reading, importance of reading, benefits of reading, how the habit of reading can be inculcated. So in your speech, you have to speak your views on reading, importance of reading. You have to tell how reading is important. Then you have to elaborate the benefits of reading. And last but not the least, you have to tell how this habit of reading can be inculcated. So students, on the basis of these value points, we have to write a specimen speech writing. So let us discuss a specimen speech writing. As we have already discussed, first we have to write a heading to our speech writing. So the heading is reading makes a ready man. Now students, after writing a heading to your speech writing, next is greetings. So you have to speak the greetings like respected teachers and friends, good morning. After greeting the audience, next comes the body of the speech writing. I would like to start my speech with a quote from the famous philosopher and author Sir Francis Bacon, reading maketh a full man. Now you can start your speech with a quote like, reading maketh a full man, means reading makes a man complete or perfect. So students, after writing a beautiful quote in the beginning of your speech, we are to elaborate our next point given in value points is views on reading. Reading is an essential basic skill building activity. One's language fluency is determined by the quality of reading. So reading is an important activity, students, that builds skill. Even fluency of language is also determined by the quality of reading. Now students, we'll elaborate another points, importance of reading and benefits of reading. So we will discuss how reading is important and what are the benefits of reading. So let us continue. Besides vocabulary enrichment, ideas collection, familiarization with different types of writing formats, speaking fluency, etc., all depend upon reading. So students, here familiarization means to make something well known to someone. So reading also enhances the understanding and expression of vocabulary. Then collection of ideas, understanding of different writing formats, fluency in speaking, all these depend upon reading. So reading not only improves our knowledge and promotes thinking, but it also develops our emotional health, thereby promoting peace and prosperity in life. So we can say reading improves our knowledge, promotes our thinking, and moreover, it also develops our emotional health. Thus, it promotes peace and prosperity in life. Reading makes a person wise and knowledgeable. There is nothing more relaxing and soothing than sitting in the corner of a room with a book in your hands. So, students, a person who reads becomes wise and knowledgeable. And moreover, if you inculcate this habit of reading, it relaxes your mind. And if you read a book sitting in the corner of your room, you will feel relaxed and calm. So, reading is the best form of self-education, and there is no limit to how much one can learn from sensible reading. So, reading is the best form of education. So, how much you learn from reading is limitless. So, besides being an excellent way of passing our time, reading gives us a welcome break from our sometimes mundane and repetitive lives. So, students, we have the words mundane and repetitive. So, it means dull and boring lives. Reading obviously is an excellent way to pass our time. It also gives us a break from our dull, boring, or monotonous works or lives. Choose from a wide variety of written material to suit your personal preference, and you will see it is a great way to feed your mind and spirit. You can store your mind with the great thoughts of the great thinkers of the world. So, students, it is highly recommended that you should choose a written material that suits your taste and choice. You will find it a great way to nourish your mind and spirit. And moreover, if you read the books of famous thinkers of the world, no doubt, whatever you read, you can store your mind with the great thoughts of those thinkers. So, the human mind is a continuous processing machine that is always seeking information, and reading is the most apt way to nourish and stimulate our mind and keep it engaged constructively, which in turn will keep it away from negative thinking. So, students, write down the meaning of stimulate, inspire, or encourage. So, the human mind is a processing machine, just like CPU of the computer, that is always getting information. So, reading is an appropriate way to nourish, nurture, and stimulate our mind, means inspires our mind to work in a constructive way so that you can be away from negative thoughts or negative thinking. So, reading also helps to keep our mental faculties sharp and intact, and it gives the mind a mental workout that does not let our mind become stale and dormant. Now, students, write down the meaning of faculties. Meaning is mental abilities. Stale means tired, and dormant means asleep. So, students, reading also helps to keep our mental abilities sharp and strong, and does not let our mind become tired and stale. As Mark Twain said, the man who does not read has no advantage over the man who cannot read. Means the man who reads has many advantages. Reading is a form of relaxation that also develops our emotional well-being by enabling us to explore and delve into new avenues. So, children, here meaning of delve is go through. So, although the benefits of reading are numerous and priceless, it is important that we read only that which does not damage our mind and keeps us away from negativity. So, obviously, we have already discussed, like, reading only keeps us away from stress and monotonous life. It relaxes our mind. And moreover, it develops our emotional health. And we have numerous benefits of reading. And moreover, reading keeps us away from every type of negativity. So students, having discussed the points, importance of reading and benefits of reading, now we will elaborate the point how the habit of reading can be inculcated. And in the end, we will discuss also the concluding paragraph. As we have already discussed, the concluding paragraph is very, very important. So, let us continue. In short, reading is a life skill. It is an investment for which you can reap profits throughout your life. So, students, reading is a life skill. It makes your life perfect and complete. So, it is an investment, means if you invest it today, you will enjoy its profit for your whole life. So, students, inculcate the habit of reading so that you can also reap its profits. Now, how can this habit of reading be inculcated? Bring the joy of reading into your lives. Make reading fun. Create a reading area. Go to a bookstore. Browse through different books and pick up what you like. So students, here browse means look around. So to inculcate the habit of reading, you have to bring the joy of reading into your lives so that you can enjoy reading, right? And make reading fun. And obviously you have to create a reading area. And for this, you have to go to a bookstore and browse through different books, and you have to pick up the book according to your taste. So, a visit to a bookstore should be a frequent and regular activity in your household. So, I would like to conclude with a quote by Russell Andel. The journey of a lifetime starts with the turning of a page. So children, this is the concluding paragraph of your speech writing, where you have to conclude what you say. As we have ended up our speech with the quote, the journey of a lifetime starts with the turning of page. So in the same way, you can conclude your speech with any of the famous quotes. So children, happy reading and thank you. So thank you must be written at the end of your speech. Now with this, we have discussed speech writing. I hope you all have understood how to write an effective speech. Now I want to discuss the important tips to attempt a question on speech writing. So students, in order to write a perfect speech, we must be well acquainted with the topic and must possess a wide range of vocabulary, a thorough knowledge of the subject. So here are some tips to help you write your perfect speech. So first point is, make sure you use language which is suitable for the audience you are addressing to. Means your language should be suitable for the audience. Next is, you can use quotes at the time of commencement of your speech or as an ending statement. Obviously, I have already discussed, you can start your speech with famous quotes or even end up your speech with famous quotes. Make sure you write in paragraphs. Obviously, we have discussed the body of the speech writing, so follow that pattern. Next is, plan before you pen. Means, students, just make a list of all your important points so that you do not forget relevant points while writing. Next is, make sure you double check for grammatical accuracy and spellings. Always have a few general quotes in. Means you must have a few quotes so that you can use those quotes in your speech writing to make it more effective. So students, your homework for the day is, you have to complete an assignment on speech writing. That is, you are the head boy or head girl of your school. Write a speech in not more than 300 words to be delivered at the morning assembly, informing the students about the precautions to be taken for protecting themselves from mosquito-borne diseases such as malaria, dengue, and chikungunya. Base your speech on the points given below. So the students, the value points are: alarming rise in the number of people suffering from mosquito-borne diseases, causes of the spread of these diseases, measures to be taken to prevent the spread of these diseases, the symptoms of these diseases, and measures to be taken in case of being afflicted with these diseases. So students must complete your assignment. Thank you.